What do you think went wrong with the petitioner's strategy?
Well, it's not so much about what went wrong, but for me, as I've already indicated, the first thing was that I did not think that the election petition was supposed to be solely on the declaration that was made by the chairperson of the Electoral Commission. Once their main target was the verbal declaration and not what had been gazetted, that is why you will find from the judgment of the panel, they do say that, yes, they admit that there was an error, but for them, the error was not substantial. And in saying the error was not substantial, you are saying that it may have just been a mere error and or something that was inadvertent. And so if it's a mere error, then if you are going by law, and that's why they quoted Section 22 of the Interpretation Act, which allows any person in authority or any person who is acting in an authoritative position and doing an act to be able to rectify any mistake that a person does. Remember also that whatever error that occurred on the 9th and it was corrected on the 10th before the final, before the gazette, which means that at the time they were correcting it, the result had not been gazetted, and so they were well within their right. That's why they say that the petitioner did not quote any law or bring any evidence that shows that the first respondent could not have corrected the mistake. And they agree with the EC that they were well within their rights to correct that mistake. And once they corrected that mistake, the person who they gazetted is the person who will be seen as validly elected. And so that was my initial reaction, that the petitioner should have mounted the petition on Article 63.9, which means they should have challenged the instrument that declared the second respondent as validly elected, and they did not do that. The other thing was also issues about the vote pardon. You realize from the evidence of PW1, which is Johnson Esedu Nketiah, that he kept on saying that they had only brought sample to show that there were some irregularity with respect to vote pardon. And when you come to a court of law, you don't bring sample evidence. You bring all the evidence that you have, because it is based on your evidence that the court can now come to a conclusion that either the irregularities you are complaining about are so substantial that it changes the outcome of the results. But if you say you only brought a sample to show that there was an irregularity, that is why they said that they were not able to prove that there was vote pardon. And even if there were vote pardon, it was not substantial to overturn the outcome of the result. So that these two things are, for me, very key issues that the petitioners could have done better.